the front page of the Advertiser in Adelaide. The headline reads, "Cops taken for fuels. Fuel thieves are escaping penalty even if they're filmed and their plates recorded under a secret police rule that says drive-offs won't be investigated unless certain criteria are met." Patrick, this seems absolutely absurd, surely.
This is funny because it's so sad because basically they don't have to do any detective work. They've got footage, they've got a number plate. And we're not talking about if you're stealing fuel, you're probably not filling up $13. You're filling up $100 to $150. They've got all the evidence they need. And there's only, I think in the story, it talks about 20 cases a day. Mm. It's not that many. Mm. For a guaranteed conviction. Mm. It beggars belief. I mean, what, are you allowed to walk into a bottle shop and just take a nice bottle of wine?
It seems crazy.
Like, why wouldn't you prosecute it?
Exactly. Mm. And, Michael, obviously cost of petrol has gone up, cost of living's biting, but surely you can't just get away with this.
No, you can't. You know, I don't know what the South Australian government's thinking. When people see governments being very weak on the enforcement of laws, they start to worry, and this is not a good sign for the South Australian government. I mean, I don't know why, as you say, Patrick, you've got footage, a number plate, you know, theft all on camera.
It's not hard.
I mean, it's not hard. Mm. I mean, you know.
And it's all handed to them, Patrick. Mm. Like, as you said, it's not like they have to run around, interview people try and find out information.
And I think I agree with Michael entirely. It sends a very bad signal. It's, it's almost giving a green light to doing this sort of thing. But you know, there's a 95% chance you're not going to get prosecuted.
Well, I think they're going to have to do something that seems absolutely ridiculous.